Welcome to the USCA AC National Championship Croquet Tournament being held late March in Venice, Florida at the Sarasota County Croquet Club. Tournament director is Jeff Soo. Assistant tournament director is Eileen Soo, and Hans Peterson is the tournament manager. This is the doubles semifinal game two. The teams are Sherif, Abdelwahab, and Stephen Morgan playing against Matthew Essick and Stuart Lawrence, who won game one.
Because a lot of times I can put up, here's what happened.
Yeah, I haven't seen the pizza come in yet.
Steven opens at what looks like maximum distance on the east boundary. Stewart's responding with corner two, or 6 inches outside of corner two.
Standard corner two response.
That's a shot.
Another way to play this would have been to send opponent blue to partner yellow on the east boundary, leaving red out by the peg, so that if yellow got in, he'd be making group one off of partner.
And the advantage of doing it this way,
it's hard to do that all the way from corner two, though.
Positioning for the rush for yellow. Then he has to make one off. Okay. No double from anywhere. So obviously not shooting the blue. Yep. Probably gonna shoot a yellow so we can get a rush on red. Or maybe red because it's shorter.
And yellow gets the first break.
I sat down for 18 hours.
Took videos.
It was really fun.
Well, you got product to show for it.
Well, yeah, right. He put black out that far. He said he's going to have to leave blue at one if he misses, and black's going to end up and have an easier shot.
So, who are the two people playing in the single finals?
Championship? Yeah. We don't know yet. They haven't had the semis yet. I think it's Zach and plays Jeff. Stuart. Don't go too fast. I want a picture of you two. This would be great.
That's David and Mika Maloof. I assumed Stephen was going to make nine, so I went and got something to eat. Turns out he bounced off three with yellow, and black was the pioneer. Matthew hit yellow with black and got in, and now is in the middle of his first break with black, approaching hoop three. And I confess, I don't know how blue got there.
Go, black. Come on now. It's such a poor shot.
As you can tell, the sun is setting basically directly behind me. And those palm shadows will gradually work their way up the lawn. He ran 4 and 5 uneventfully, and now we'll watch the lead develop. Chris Clark has about 3 paragraphs on where that red ball should be. It should not be rushable to hoop 1 in case the opponent gets in. You shouldn't be able to see more than a half ball from the end of B ball. And it should have a clear view of corner 4 in case they shoot from corner 3, you get in and mess up at hoop 1, wired from the ball that can't be rushed to hoop 1. In addition, he wants it close to the hoop because you might have to shoot at it from a distance and it won't bounce off very far, hopefully.
Red is so beautifully played.
Getting all of those is tough. And probably the most important one is don't give him a good shot from B-ball.
He'll make three back last. Mm-hmm. Then we'll put his clip on four back. It's easy to screw this up. Also wants it rushable to hoop one if possible. And in general, see, now he's gonna have a little bit of trouble. In general, the triple is easier if they leave. He leaves yellow there, they don't pick it up. But
he went to make sure it was wired from the end of A block, and then deciding where he has to put his ball so yellow can't have a whack at them. Parity doesn't mean much here because yellow's only on two and red's on one. I can't tell exactly where he's aiming that. The standard concern is not to leave a double from a bomb, but it looks like he's pretty much aiming at hoop one. A nice new standard lead. They'll probably pick up yellow to make blue's triple peel a little bit harder. And because if he hits blue or black, it's easy to get back to hoop three and get a three ball break going.
It's easy to get back up.
After two, he ran a nicely controlled break to three back, which he's about to make, setting up his diagonal spread. Thank you. a nice diagonal spread, being careful not to leave a double target from bot, because you know he's going to lift blue. And since red and yellow are effectively guarding corner four, there's no advantage to the long shot from corner three.
You can go in front horn.
So he's taking the short shot from the end of A ball. If he were rushing to hoop one, he probably would have hit blue first and taken yellow over there, but he's rushing to an opponent ball at the peg, so he's leaving partner by the boundary to come back to if things go awry. He was trying for the rush back to yellow to facilitate the triple. Reds for two, blues for one, black and yellow are on four back. Black, the back ball, is taking the shot. Yellow corners, getting away from hoop one, which is blue's hoop. That doesn't happen very often at this level. Red is for hoop two.
I smell a triple coming on. Better get it too, or they'll do it to him.
Okay, a delayed triple.
It was a hell of a scatter shot.
Red's clip is on two, so he should be able to make substantial progress if he can hit yellow and then get back to blue and black without rolling out.
What the hell is he doing? Oh, that's the key. Oh my God.
You'll have to look at minute 6 in game 1 to understand why that's so funny. A new and effective use of the furniture in croquet. Very impressive distance control for a pass roll, especially.
harder than you.
Nice peel, perfect rush. He should play more often with his hat on. Ooh, we rushed yellow into perfect peeling position at Pinault, but I predict he'll resist the temptation to do that before he makes six. Great shot. He'd much rather jaws that than have it just trickle through.
say late September. Wednesday's going to be pretty good. Yeah. Well, really, when they pick up. Keep turning water off for a week and I don't think you're long for any danger. given the starting point they have it. AC is interesting.
And the jaws are going to shut.
And
just get it in the jaw. Right there.
Can't double tap a ball you're dead on. I think red was just a little bit too close. That shot has been the subject of a number of high-speed video studies on YouTube. It's not easy. Sherif took red from hoop two to rover, getting all three peels on yellow. Blue is on four, wants to play, of course. Black is on four back. Stuart will try to find some way to make the triple work, even from hoop four. On the bench over there are Eileen Sue, our very effective assistant tournament director, and Mike Albert, who won 4 of 7 games in the block but didn't feel well enough to play in the knockout.
Triple. Well, it's just like finishing a sex double.
Yeah.
Get the peel before what?
He wants to try to get this peel on the way to six. Okay. So he wants yellow to be his escape ball here.
Right.
So he has to get black in peeling position, yellow is escape ball.
And then make five.
And make five. It's one of those things that it sounds great until you have a bad rug, and then everything goes to hell. So.
And in the meantime, you don't want to break down.
So. Exactly. So I think what he's going to do is. It's a really weird angle. You know what I mean? It's hard to get two yellow and get the ball down.
Right.
But as long as it gets two yellow, it really doesn't matter how far the ball gets down. That's great.
Yeah, because you can reposition the PLE again.
Yeah, yeah. He's going to have a chance too. That's actually perfect. Nice shot. Yeah, he wants to make it a pretty firm. Yeah, that's perfect.
ball position as a score spot. Yes, yes. So the escape ball is going to be your final. Now, think about this shot, but. That's perfect. Nice shot. And a little bit longer.
Positioning. The escape ball from so far away is not advised, but what the hell?
But, think about it. You'd rather that ball be there for sure. Right. Short, you can't use it. You can't even try the field because then you'll have a 7 or 8 yarder, you don't want that. And I would say that close to 50% of triples mess up on loop 5 because people try to get a rush out of 5 to get down there.
Right.
It's one of those things that you don't need, but people won't throw them out. Exactly. I've seen more people stuff three back, or not stuff each other on this approach. Something happened to three back this time.
Leaving yellow as a skate ball from what he hopes will be the penult peel after one back. So, does black go to two back or to penult? He scored one back. Nice little pivot swap.
don't get many better than that. David and Jeff are both very, very good people. The thing that he's so good at is he's good at relating to all people. Regardless of who you are, you can really be a not the best of
you got the rush you needed, all right. Sweet. Should he corner here, let yellow set a lead, or try this hoop shot? You can see on the balls, yellow is for the peg, red is for rover, black is for rover, and blue is for four back.
Blame the damn groundskeeper for that.
Are you guys going to get something to eat before you do the next one?
I'm good. Sherif and Steven even it up in the second game with a 26-20 win over Matthew and Stuart on a triple peel by Sherif. Game 3 coming up.